Ooh. I never heard nothing like this. And I don't know if Josh did it this morning, but this is sort of a cautionary tale. If anybody out there likes black licorice, which is crazy because I think it's
love
awful.
Black licorice.
Do you really?
Oh,
it's terrible.
Yeah, you either love it or you hate it.
This will never happen to me, but there is a man, 50-year-old construction worker up in Boston, who died. Mm-hmm. He died because he ate too much black licorice. He overdosed on the black licorice and his
heart
stopped.
He probably had a pre-existing condition.
No. Doctors
tell
you.
Tell me more.
It didn't take that much black licorice to kill a dude. He ate about a bag and a half every day for just a few weeks.
Oh, that's a lot.
It is a lot. He switched over from the red licorice. I mean, I'm thinking Twizzlers, right?
Mm-hmm.
But they say eating as little as 2 ounces of black licorice a day for 2 weeks could cause a heart rhythm problem, especially for people over 40 years old. This is from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. This guy, being 54, should have known better. But the problem, how would you know? That's why I figured I would, get this out there. How much black licorice do you like, really?
A bag and a half of any candy is way too much every day. That's bonkers.
Yeah. Well, the problem
is... I think if you ate candy corns, that much candy corns, you would...
Too much anything, right?
Committed.
The problem is...
People hate candy corns, too.
Oh, no question about it.
I love it.
It's glycyrrhizic acid. Found in black licorice and in many other foods and dietary supplements containing licorice root extract. It can cause dangerously low potassium and imbalances in other minerals.
I should have had a banana.
Right. And he switched over. Like I said, he was eating a different kind. He switched from the red fruit flavored twist to the black licorice version a few weeks before his death. So they narrowed in, figured it out. Mm-hmm. And they say there's other stuff, too. It's more than licorice. It could be jelly beans, licorice teas, a lot of things over the counter. Even some beers, like Belgian beers, have this compound in it, as do some chewing tobaccos. So watch yourself. If you like that type of thing, which I think I'm safe.
Huh. Yeah. I could see teas doing that, too, because that flavoring is in everything. Shouldn't there be a warning on the package?
I know.
You could die.
But would you look at it if you really like black licorice? I mean, if you like smoking, it's got a warning on it too, but people still smoking. I guess
because I know about smoking. I don't know. I would be curious. I would probably look into it. Because I remember in California, they have a lot of the notices where they say, this could cause birth defects.
Sure.
And that gave me pause. And I would look it up and I'm like, are the odds low? Or, I would appreciate a little warning label slapped on there.
Well, Jeff Beckman, he's a spokesman for the Hershey Company, which makes a popular Twizzlers licorice twist, said in an email, quote, all of our products are safe to eat and formulated in full compliance with FDA regulations. And they should be enjoyed in moderation.
Yeah. Just like McDonald's with, Supersize Me.
Yeah.
They don't say have McDonald's every single meal every day for months. They say, come on in for dinner every now and then.
There are some people that have McDonald's or Burger King. Or how about Joe M. Robinson? Lives right near a Chick-fil-A. How much Chick-fil-A you think he's eating? But
he'll be the next story.
If you work next to a McDonald's, and that I bet some people eat.
Or if you work there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. If you work there, you're excited to get that meal.
Right.
Right on.
Well, another warning then, perhaps.
Yes,
try
indeed.
A vegetable. There are so many ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com, or the 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. So give us a follow on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.